Now we will learn how to fit the motor into the driving wheel. You can see this notch. When you press it, it will release. So now to fix this, you can see this groove and this particular portion, groove in this particular driving wheel. Now to fix this motor, we have to put this groove on this particular side. Adjust it through this. You can see there is a deep and a, you can see here there is a groove, and so these two groove must match with each other. To match this groove, when we put this inside, if it doesn't match, we pull this particular adapter a little henceforth, and then it gets firmly inside. Once it is inside, just rotate this particular thing with this pulling up and rotate, and it locks. See, once again from this view, once I have firmly put this inside, if it doesn't fix, just move a little bit, it will fix, it will move inside properly. And once it is in place, we just need to pull this up, pull this lever up and rotate, and then leave the lever and it will lock. To remove this motor, just pull this lever up and then rotate and remove. This is a simple mechanism to fix the motor. Now, this motor is S model. This is a S model motor. It has got four wires. One is brown, other is black, and there is a blue, and there is a yellow green. Yellow green is earthing. This is neutral. And brown and black, one is clockwise motion, another is anti-clockwise motion. Brown and black. One is anti-clockwise motion, and another is anti-clockwise motion. When you supply the power, you put neutral here and phase in any one of this, the motor will start moving in one direction. And when you remove from brown and put it on black phase and neutral as it is common, the motor will move in another direction. So this is the four wires which you have to connect. Earthing you connect or may not connect depending upon your site situation. I have given power, I have connected blue wire to neutral, and this red wire is a phase. When I put this, the motor operate in one direction, and when I put on another, the motor operate in another direction. Now, after one operation, it remembers its place, and the next time it stops a little earlier. And thus it will not make any noise. Now, how to mount this particular curtain system on the ceiling. This is a ceiling bracket. You require 4 pieces in 12 feet. That means every 4 feet you require one piece. Okay. groove over here which goes inside the bracket. You can in the top side of the track you can see one groove here and another groove on this side. Now sealing bracket, we put it in this fashion and then lock it from another side. This is how you remove the lock, put it the lock and tight it. Similarly, we can mount another bracket. Loose it a little bit so that it moves freely and then tight. This way, this is a stiff bracket. It gets mounted on the curtain track. Now, to put it on the ceiling, we lift it up, mark it, and do the drill hole. Okay. Now, once ceiling bracket is drilled on the ceiling, and if we need to remove this track, we don't need to unmount the screw. We just need to put this screw, loosen the screw, remove this bracket, come this side, loosen this screw, rotate it, and then just simply tilt a little and the bracket will come out. And this will be fixed on the top side in the ceiling as it is. So you can mount this first, but it should be in a straight line. All the ceiling brackets should be in a straight line in the top ceiling, and make sure it is in the same direction. Make sure all the things, backside is and the front side are in the same direction. This is a wrong way. One on this side, another on that side. This is a wrong way of mounting. All should be in the same direction. So when you try to put this and lock it, it becomes easier. If it is in opposite direction, you cannot lock it. Okay.